Good morning, students. We already started the English grammar. In the last video, we started noun. In that, we learn about the noun and various kinds of noun. Let's recall it. See, here we have a definition of noun. Noun. A noun is a word used as a name for a person, place, animal, or thing. It can also describe an abstract idea. A noun is called a naming word. Whenever we are talking about the noun, that is a naming word. Just forget the definition. Just keep in your mind that things that noun is a naming word. As because in the nature, in the world, whatever the things are present, each and every ones are having their own names. Take an example of the persons, as we learn the definition, name of the person. I, you, our parents, our friends, every person on this earth, they have their name, their own names, for identifying to them. The particular name that is called noun. Whenever we are talking about the place, we have a lot of the places, like, if we have to take the examples of the countries like India, Australia, South Africa, America, these all are the name of the countries. Cities, we have a lot of the cities in our own country. Mumbai, Delhi, Chandigarh, Pune, Nagpur, etc. Whenever we are talking the animals, we have a lot of the animals. They are also having their own name. Lion, tiger, dog, horse, cow, etc. Along with this all, if we are talking about our abstract ideas, like our emotions or feelings, they're also considered in the nouns. Now, move for the kinds of noun. There are two main types of noun, concrete noun and abstract noun. Whenever we are talking about the concrete noun, that means the name, the noun, what we can see, what we can touch, what we can feel, what we can taste. Yes, that all are considered in the noun. Like, if I am talking about this marker, so I can see this marker, I can touch this marker, I can write by this marker, means I am using this. So whenever we have the such kinds of the words of noun, that comes within the concrete noun. The concrete noun is bifurcated in the four types. The first one is proper noun, second one is common noun, third one is collective noun, fourth one is material noun. Proper noun, a particular name of the place, person, things or any idea. Common noun, a name that we are using commonly for the things. Collective noun, one as whole. For the main same kind of the things, we are using a same noun, same name, that is called noun. Collective noun. Material noun, the things by using we are making the many other things, that's called material noun. So in the last video, we learned about the proper noun in details. Now move for the second one, common noun. Common noun is bifurcated in the two parts, countable noun, uncountable noun. What we are able to count, that comes within countable noun, and what we are not able to count, that comes within the uncountable noun. So let's move in detail what is common noun. A common noun refers to name of person, place, animal or things in general that are called common noun. Take an example. First we are talking about the persons. If I'm talking about the king, the word king is a common noun. Why? As because whenever we are talking about the kings, means there are a lot of the various kings. There are different kinds of the kings, various kings in our history. So if we are not talking about the one of the specific. If I am talking about the Akbar, the King Akbar, the King Shivaji. So means that time we are specifically, particularly talking about that person. But if I am talking about the king, that is not a specific name of any person, so that's come within a common noun. If I'm talking about the teacher, that also the same, doctor,
एटसेट्रा.
दिस ऑल आर कम्स विद इन अ कॉमन नाउन. दिस वे वी कैन से दिस ऑल आर कम्स विद इन अ कॉमन नाउन. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज प्लेस. वेन यू वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्लेस लाइक रिवर और वी कैन से सिटी कंट्री एटसेट्रा मीन्स these all are the few common names by that we can use to denote all the kinds of various things. Like if I'm talking about the river, there are various kinds of different rivers in our country, so we are not identifying that. Like we have the Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, Krishna, Kaveri. These all are the various kinds of rivers. If you are talking about the city, we have a lot of the cities in our country: Mumbai, Nagpur, Delhi, Chandigarh, Hyderabad, Bangalore. Means we are not talking about any specific city. Same like the countries and so on. The next one is like animals. Dog, horse, cow, etc. Now, by seeing these name of the animals, you don't be confused. As because we are thinking like if I'm talking the dog, so not that is a proper noun. As because dog is a common name for each of the kind of this various species of the dog. We have the bulldogs in there and other various kinds of the dogs. So we are not identifying the various species of that dog. So because of that, name of the animals also comes within a common noun. If I'm talking the horse, cow and other animals, the same thing will be repeated in that. Each and every animal having their own different kinds of the species. Because of that, they all are considered in the common noun. The next one, things. If we are talking the things like furniture or we can say equipments, ornaments, etc. These all are the things which are commonly used for the various kinds of the things. Like if I'm talking the furniture, table, chair, bench, etc. All the things are included in there. So whenever we have the such kinds of common name for the things, that is called common noun. Now next move for the next type of the noun, collective noun. A collective noun is the name of group of a person. That is the most important thing. Group means collective noun is representing a group of person or things or belonging to the same kinds. Person, place or things, animal, that all are belonging to the same kind. Or we can say they are considered one complete whole. Means one, that word, whatever we are using as a collective noun, that is representing, that is stand one complete whole. Like we have the example team. Whenever we are talking about the team, that means there are the various peoples are included in there. For an example, if I am talking about the cricket team, so there are 11 members in that team. So for that 11 people, the word, the single word comes and stand for that as a team. Flock. Flock means that is whenever we have a lot of the animals together, that is called flock. Bunch, etc. These all are having the word which consider the same kind of the various team. Take an example, how we can see in a sentence. India is one of the best cricket team. In this example, till now what we learned, all things should become like. If I am talking about India, that is the name of the country, proper noun, cricket.
Cricket also one specific name of the type of game. So it is also considered as a proper noun. But this team, this name, team. Team means all the 11 people of the team comes together and they call as a team. So this is called a collective noun. So in this way we can say when a single word stands to make a complete whole, that is called a collective noun. Now move for the next type, that is material noun. What is material noun? Material noun is, a material noun is the name of material from which many things are made. By using that things, many things are made. Like we are wearing a clothes that are made by the different kinds of the materials like cotton, silk, fabric, etc. I have the marker. This marker is used by using the metal plastics. We have the lot of the ornaments that are made by using the gold. So by using that metals or the things, we can say the lot of the things are made. That is called material noun. For example, I have a gold ring. In this, we can say that gold, this word gold, identifying, denoting the ring is made by this metal, that is gold. So it is called a material noun. Yes, this way we can say whenever we are having anything by using that, the anything should be made, that is called material noun. Now move for the next main second types of the noun, that is abstract noun. An abstract noun names an idea or a quality or a taste. An abstract noun cannot be seen, that is most important, cannot be seen, heard, smelled, touched or tasted. It can only be felt or experienced. First, abstract noun, the name of an idea or the quality, means whenever we are talking about the abstract noun, that means we are talking about an idea or the quality of the people. Like if I am talking about the quality of any people, he is very honest person. So honesty, we cannot measure this honesty, or we can say there is no any weapon by using that we can measure the honesty of any persons. So whenever we have the, just like the things, we cannot see, we cannot touch it, we cannot observe it, just we have to feel it, we have to experience it. Such kinds of the names and nouns comes within the category of abstract noun. Like if I am talking about the, he is very honest, we are not able to see that honesty, but there is any of the incident should be happened by that we can experience the honesty of him. We can say that on the basis of that he is very honest. Or we can say rich, richness of the person, he is very rich. Do we are able to see that richness of that person? No. To see the things what he have by the activity, we can feel that he is a very rich person, he is very rich, he has a lot of the money. So we can experience that. Whenever we have the such kinds of things, we can say that is a abstract noun. For example, Ram is a very poor boy. In this example, you can see the word come poor means Ram is very poor. We cannot see the poverty of this person Ram, but by the behavior of that person, by the situation, we can feel, we can experience the poorness of that person. So we can say Ram is a poor boy. Or we can say the second example, C is very kind in nature. So the kindness of her, we are not able to see, but we can experience it. we can feel it. So we can say that is a abstract noun. So once again, whenever we have any of the quality or idea, what we are not able to see, we are not able to heard or smell or touch, but we can feel it, we can experience it, then such kinds of the types of noun comes within the abstract noun.
So today we learn about the noun, two types of noun, concrete and abstract noun. Within concrete noun, we learn about the four types of the noun: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, and material noun. So today we finish all the various kinds of noun, and we learn how we are going to identify the various types of noun. So you have the homework for today. Pick out the noun and write its various kinds. Akbar has a vast empire and a strong army. I danced with joy. The fabric was made of cotton. Fried foods contain a lot of salt and spices. People of all communities and tribes participate in the festivals. So, this way we can write the various kinds of nouns within a sentence. For an example, like in the first one, first you are going to underline the names like Akbar, Empire, Strong, and Army. Now, after underlining that, you should be write one by one below the statement, and along with the name, write the which kinds of the noun that is. In this way, you have to complete your homework and submit it in a group. Thank you so much.